This video is sponsored by Avail. Are you a HGV driver looking for a job? If so, then create and log into the Avail app and start looking for work. Want to know more? Then download the Avail app today.
Good morning.
Welcome to the channel. My name's Luke. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. We are in the RV. We are in Leighton Buzzard, parked up for the night, and we're just about to turn the engine on.
Okay, foot on the brake. Start. Lovely.
Get some lights on in here. And we can now go on the work. So while the engine is warming up, we're gonna pop out, do some checks. Let's turn some lights on, hazards on. We're gonna go outside and make sure everything is working. Oh, before I continue, yes, we have GoPros on today. So yeah, don't worry about it. We will see some on-screen action, on the road action, I should say. Okay, here she is. Lights seem to be working, tyres are inflated, load is secure, got a load of roof and tiles. It's literally just going from South Cerny to Leighton Buzzard. Once we tip this, we've got to go back to South Cerny again. That's kind of twisted, yeah. We've got to go back to South Cerny from here, go get another load, and then bring it back again. So, nice easy day today. Okay, lights are working. We're going to the back of the trailer. So yeah. Just in case you didn't hear me, so Leighton Buzzard, we've got a tip. Let's do this one up, it's a bit loose. Tip this in Leighton Buzzard, go back to South Cerny, get another load, come back to Leighton Buzzard, and that's today. Nice and easy, and then probably go get loaded somewhere for the next day, for Tuesday. Yeah, all seems to be good. Lights are on. Happy days. Happy days. Airlines are all in place. Not tangled. They look good. I got this washed yesterday, but doesn't look like it. I'm trying to keep it clean. Yeah. Anyway, let's jump in the truck. Okay, right. Checks are done, paperwork is done. Everything is done. Let's turn the lights off. Phone can go up there out the way, which actually needs to go on charge. Okay, hazard lights off. Right, we are good to go. Let's put it in reverse. We can't quite get out. We parked quite close to this lorry in front of us so that we weren't blocking what was behind us. If I go back far enough, you'll see. There we go. So basically this little entrance here on the right, I was not blocking, but just making sure I wasn't interfering basically. So yes. Anyway, armrest down. Yeah, today could go quite easily. We're parked basically 15 minutes away. That's a nice looking daff, look. We parked 15 minutes away, less than actually, from where we're delivering this morning. We're gonna be there first thing this morning. Be there before 7 a.m. Hopefully we can get tipped quite quickly, and then I think it's like 2 and a bit hours back. So I'm hoping to be back in Swindon by about 10-ish. Say I'm loaded then by about 11-ish, back in Leighton Buzzard for about 1-ish, 2-ish, gotta get a break in, and then back in Swindon, you know, before 5, basically. That's the plan. But I don't know whether I'm getting loaded later or not, or where, so. That is something I have to... No, we can't go that way. Why is it telling us to go that way? It's a weight limit. Satnav was saying go left, but that's a weight limit down there. Oh, I didn't realise that shop was there. Good to know. So yeah, both these places we are loading at and delivering at. I'm not entirely sure how much I can film. So I will probably just show the load on the trailer when we get loaded. I probably won't do too much filming in Leighton Buzzard because I don't know them quite as well and I don't want to get in trouble, so yeah. It's going to be mostly driving, I reckon, in this video, and it'll probably only be a short one as well, but it's something. It's something. And this is the first vlog in the Iveco with the GoPros, other than driving back from Shepton Mallet, and that wasn't really a vlog, so that was more of a just get used to it sort of thing. But yeah, man, this is the first vlog with GoPros in the Iveco. I've been looking at all your comments, and yeah, I agree with some of you. There isn't a lot of space in here. It is relatively poorly specced in that regards. It'd be nice to have a bit more storage. I've only got two lockers, essentially. So yeah, more storage would be nice. I'm not sure what's happening, because I've been told that I can't have lockers and aircon unit at the back, because it takes up too much space or something. And also I heard that it means you've got to remove the centre console panel. I really like that centre console panel. I don't really want it to go, to be honest. So, yeah, that's something's going to happen in the future regarding that. I don't know what. But yeah, it is looking quite bland in here at the moment. I need to add some of my own stuff to it, like light board, curtains, floor mats. I mean, they are all on order. They've been on order now for about a month, actually. I've paid 400 quid off my own money for it, and I'm still waiting for it to be made and turn up. But once it's here, I'll put it in. And yeah, I just need to basically make it my own a bit more, put some more stuff around it, make it less bland. I do agree, it does look a bit bare inside. We're on it. We're working that one out. Anyway, subscriber count is going up nice and quickly. So thank you very much for all of you who are subscribing to my channel. I do appreciate it. If you haven't already hit that subscribe button, feel free to hit it. It doesn't cost you a penny. I think I had 74,000 subscribers on my last video. I've got 74,100 subscribers now. So we gained 100 subscribers in a couple of days. So that's really good. Really nice. Thank you very much. Let's keep going. Get that 75,000 mark. And then it's the road to 100,000. And then I reckon once I get to 100,000 subs, I reckon I'm going to do a massive giveaway. I reckon. We'll sort something out later on. Ugh, bump. But yeah, I'm going to do a massive giveaway, I reckon. Anyway, I'm going to crack on to Leighton Buzzard. We're only about 15 minutes away. I probably won't film the arrival, but I will show you a little bit once we're inside. I'll see you in a bit. So as you can see, we're inside now. We are tipping, well, we're unstrapping, I should say. Then we're going to get our paperwork checked. And then they can tip us. And then the plan is basically, if we take all the straps off now, get in the truck, get the paperwork signed and everything, and then we ain't got to get back out again. Stay in the truck, they offload us. As soon as they finish offloading us, we can just crack straight on back to South Surrey to get the second load for today. Being taken off, you can just about see. I could have probably given that mirror a clean, can't I? It's one of those things where it always looks worse on camera than it does in life, in real life. But yeah, take that one off. And then we got four more pallets? Yeah, four more pallets left on that side as well. So yeah, nearly done. We're just sat in the bunk at the moment. They don't let us sit in the driver's seat, so I'm supposed to sit in the passenger seat, but I've got stuff down there. What with being a tramper of sorts. Tramping, by the way, means you stay away from home. I live in the truck.
Well, I think the last one's coming off now, I think. Yep. All good. Right, let's jump back in the driver's seat. Take this hi-vis off. We don't want to be wearing it any longer than we have to. It's getting bright out there. Might have to put the old sunglasses on. Which one is it? What one? Give this window a quick wipe, like I just said. get on out of here. Turn my lights off now. Too light for the lights. Got hazards and beacons on still. Hazards and beacons are requirements. Okay, hazards are off now. We can indicate left and dash cam footage can go back on. Because I don't want to film too much inside. And it's not bright now either, look. Lovely. So yeah, let's crack on to South Cerny. And yeah, so we're going to go get another load. Bring that back to here, a later buzzard. And then I don't what we're doing from there exactly, I don't actually know. So we'll just have to wait and see on that one. I would imagine from we're going to be empty here. I don't know what you're going to get us to do. You might just take us back empty. I don't know. Thank you, Mr. Tipper Driver. Dazza said in the nameplate in the window. Thank you, Dazza. Appreciate it. So yeah, we'll head back. It's going to be about 10 o'clock, I think, by the time we get back. I want to do a couple of things. I got, it's behind me on the bunk. I've got like a chest piece, like a mount of GoPro onto my chest. I'm thinking about doing some POV, like driving or POV loading up, like strapping and stuff. I don't know. Just thinking. I'm not sure whether I can do it or not. We'll see. The problem with the GoPros is that they overheat and they die. If you record for too long, they overheat and they stop recording, which is a bit annoying. And you've got to let them cool down again, and then you can start them again using voice commands. Good yass. Anyway, we're going to crack on to South Cerny now. I will see you when we get there, so we'll see you in a bit. Right, you join me in South Cerny. We are just driving down now to go and get loaded. Time is getting on. A little bit concerned of how time is getting on. So I was hoping to be here like 9, 10, something like that. It's actually 10 to 11. We got held up in a bit of traffic. Not a lot we can do about that. We're probably going to be here for an hour or so. I can't imagine we'll be here much more than an hour. So say 12 o'clock, hopefully we leave in just over an hour's time. If we left now, it's 1 o'clock. So we should, fingers crossed, be back in Leighton Buzzard by 2 o'clock. That's fine. I need to get a break in as well. So maybe 1:30, 2:45. Not gonna be a big deal. I think we still get it tipped. Not gonna be an issue. I just thought maybe we'd be there an hour or so earlier. But what can you do? That sun is a bit bright. So we're just gonna park up here. There's two trucks in there now currently getting loaded. And where'll it be next?
Right, we're loaded. Just went to pop to the toilet. How crazy is this though? Have a look at this. This whole, I don't know if you can see, the whole of the grass. The whole thing. Covered with bees. I think they're bees. The whole thing.
So yeah, as I was saying, loaded. Those bees are a bit weird. I don't think they're like honeybees. They're just different type of bee, I think. Also, shout out to Wendy and Jamie. Jamie drives for Keedwell. He's just over there. Just over there. He's come over and said hello to me. And then obviously I nipped to the toilet over there, come back and he had his wife on FaceTime. So shout out to Wendy and Jamie. Hopefully you get home nice and safe, mate. Just gotta connect my Bluetooth back to my system. Right, let's get out of here. I don't know if I've mentioned enough. I love the cord seats on this truck. Air-cooled seats, it's amazing. Wave to my mate over there. Right, so, let's crack on out of here. So we're all strapped up, it's all got corner boards on, we're good to go. Yeah, I had a little break, so strapped up and then put it on break for 15 minutes, went to the toilet, did my thing. You don't need to know what I was doing in the toilet. But let's just say I had a 15 minute break. And so we only need half an hour break now later on. So that's good. Let this car through. We can make that. So yeah, we've got enough drive time to get back to Leighton Buzzard, get this chipped, and then we'll probably have a break. If we can, we'll have one on site. If not, then obviously we'll pull up and have one somewhere. It's going to be no big deal. We'll find somewhere to have a break, but let's not block any lay-bys. Of course, this used to be the old yard here on the left where I used to park. Anyone there we know? No. No tooting of the yawns. No one there that we know. Oh, I'm going to buy a new car tomorrow. It's not brand new and it's not bought outright. It'll be on finance. But all the checks are done. It's all been complete. It's a brand new... It's a new car for my wife. A Ford Tourneo 8-seater. In my name. I would be the owner, but it's for her child minding, taking kids out and about, but also it's ideal for us as a family, you know, if we want to go on holiday, got plenty of storage, and obviously our dog as well, Lando the dog. I don't know whether I've spoken about my dog on these vlogs. I've definitely spoken about him on Facebook and Instagram if you follow me on there, but I've got a beautiful dog called Lando the Labrador. He's black. And he's such a cutie. Very, very well behaved. Well, is he well behaved? No, he does bark a little bit and bite a little bit, but that's, you know, he's a puppy. But he's very good at like commands. You tell him to sit, he will sit. You know, say down, it go down. I'm trying to teach him paw at the moment and fetch, bring stuff back. But yeah, he's a little cutie. Anyway, we're gonna crack on to Leighton Buzzard now. It's a good couple of hours drive there. Get this tipped, and then, like I said, I don't actually know what I'm doing from Leighton Buzzard. I would assume it'd be back to the yard, or maybe go get loaded somewhere. I don't know, depends on what time we can get back. I personally think we wouldn't be getting back to Swindon until about 5 o'clock, so chances of actually being loaded anywhere this area, so like Be Right or where we just got loaded or Tetbury, that's very slim. Unless we got loaded somewhere else near Leighton Buzzard, I can't see us getting loaded today. Ready for next week, but we will see. Anyway, I'll see you in a little while. See you in a bit. We're in trouble here. We haven't moved in ages. We're on the A420, literally about just under a mile away from the A34. I think there's been an accident on the A34. Huh. Yeah, it's gonna delay us a little bit today. To the extent that I don't know whether it's gonna get tipped off today or not now. Okay, cars are moving up ahead. Are we moving completely or is it just like a little bit? This is the question. Oh, this is not good. Not good for a Friday. It's always on a Friday, isn't it? See, trouble is, I don't know whether they've shut the A34 on or not. I might get down to the end of this traffic and then see that they've closed it all off. Just trying to think which way I can have to go then. I don't know. I have to go straight over into sort of Oxford and then sort of go left somehow over there. I don't know. Yeah, I think if I can't go left, then I'll go right and go round Oxford the other way and then sort of go diagonally up towards Aylesbury. I think Tame, going via Tame will take me there. This is what annoys me, cars coming down the left side and just having that to wait or queue, but they just go, whoop, I'll go straight in here. Just looking on the...
Slow traffic on A420. Traffic jam ahead between A34, E5 Southern Bypass Road and A420 Westway. 12 minutes delay.
Is there really a traffic jam? Thanks for just telling me. I think the traffic is going on the A34 going right. I think my way going left is completely clear. This person's undone their window just so they can put their hand up at me to say thanks. Yeah, I've got a funny feeling that we will be fine going left. It's just getting there to go left. I think all this traffic is queuing up to go right, I think. Mind you, there's new signs up saying left only in this lane. We used to be able to go all the way around in this lane. Go on, put your hand up, say thank you. There we go. See, I think people are going to start seeing these signs now and hopefully get into the correct lanes, which is causing a bit more congestion because people are swapping around. Yeah, so this is new. You used to be able to go A34 south in both lanes. Both lanes went round to the right. But now, look, there's signage and signs on the floor as well. Left only in the left lane. Not even straight over, just left only. That's what it's saying. Because that was the other thing. You can go in this lane, you can go straight over and you could go right. But that's now changed. Left only, which in theory, because that's like, if you're coming this way, chances are you're going up, not down. So in theory, that's going to make things a bit quicker, but obviously not right now, it isn't. Get the feeling this blue Lindab truck wants to go left. Just a feeling. Right, yeah, this left lane is definitely going quicker than the right lane, so I am pretty sure that it's just people queuing up to go right on the A34, which is south. We want to go north. I'm pretty sure we should be able to jump straight on. Yes, look at this, look. We're definitely going. We're flying in the left lane. Don't change, don't change, don't change, don't change, don't change. Don't change. Stay green, stay green, stay green. Was a bit snug. Make it. Yeehaw! Yep, so it's just everyone literally queuing to go right, like I thought. That was a little bit annoying. Never mind. Right. We're on the carriage rate. Oh my god, we've got to come back this way. We've got to come back this way. I might deliberately go another way to come back. Oh god, I've got a broken down car here. It's all clear. Yes, might go back a different way, not go back via the A420. Look at all this traffic coming down. It's just for that, I think it's just the roundabout, you know, causing the issue. I think that's literally it. Look at all this traffic. Nah. Yeah, we'll go back another way. Right, I'm going to crack on. I'll see you when we're at Leighton Buzzard. See you in a bit. Right, we are just a couple of miles away from Leighton Buzzard. There's a car behind me with a sofa on its roof. I'm not even joking. There's a sofa on the roof. Is that a Mini? Is that like Mr. Bean? No, that's not a Mini. I don't think you're going to see it. I don't think there's an opportunity for them to overtake me, but never mind. Yeah, so we're just around the corner now from Leighton Buzzard where we will get unloaded. We'll be here for a little while whilst we undo all the straps and find out what we're doing. I don't actually know what we're doing next from here. I will message the boss once we turn up and I'll find out. I have just had a horrible, horrible feeling that it could be loading from Shep and Swindon. I really hope that's not the case. Because, well, if it is, it is. But that's a late finish for Friday. I wouldn't get there till like half past 5, 6 o'clock. And, well, we know how long they can take. But, yeah, that wouldn't be very nice. Let's hope it's not Shep and Swindon. Let's hope. You might see the car, because if we slow down enough, it'll undertake us on the left-hand side. Yeah, there we go. There's the car. It's got a sofa on its roof. Not going to make that. Was going to make that, but then the Land Rover come around the corner, so I wasn't going to make it. Now we can go. If it wasn't for that Land Rover coming around, I would have carried on. Never mind. Right, so yeah, we're nearly here now. I will see you once we're inside. Like I said, I don't really want to film too much inside, like dash cam wise. I think I can get away with filming myself and the load whilst I'm inside, but I don't want to show like driving around inside too much, if that makes sense. So I will see you in a little bit. Hopefully we've got all the straps off. Let's get these corner boards. Lovely, lovely. Right, we are in position to be loaded, unloaded. Straps are off, quarter boards are off. Just need all them taken off. Once that's done, we can crack on. Still don't know where we are going, mind you. I've messaged the boss, but I haven't got a reply back, so I'm probably gonna give him a call in about 5 minutes.
You will arrive at your destination at 17:10.
If we went straight back to the yard. But I think we need to get a break in as well on the way back, so we're gonna run out of time. Just waiting for a text. Please don't be chat. Please don't be chat. Chat. That's right. Please don't be chat. Please don't be chat. Please don't be chat. Back to yard. Honestly, I honestly thought he was going to say, go to chat. Oh, I'm so glad it's not that. I mean, I love chat. Chat's amazing. But on a Friday, no thank you. Okay, we are now sat on the bunk, which means we are getting unloaded because we're not allowed in the driver's seat, which is fair enough. I did say, didn't I, back to the yard. So yeah, we'll go back to the yard, wash the truck because it is minging, and then we'll be done for the day. I'm so glad it's not yet. I really am. I know I've already said this, but I'm still not 100% convinced. I have a feeling that I'll get back and it'll be like, yeah, chip. I'm hoping that's not the case. Right, you join me just leaving Leighton Buzzard. We've just gone to the end of the road. It's all clear to get out of here. Bang tidy. It's a bit messy behind me. I've just started tidying up, so all the rubbish has been put away, ready to leave. Put it in the bin when we get back to the yard, or put it in my car actually and drive home with it and then put it in my bin. We need a bin in the yard. An accessible bin. ETA back to the yard is like 6 o'clock, give or take. Probably got to wash the truck as well. It's, like I said, it's a little bit dirty, so it needs at the very least, it just needs a blast with water, get all the dust off. I have gone over it throughout the week, so it's not like terrible. You've seen it in today's video a little bit, I think. So it's not terrible, but yeah, there are a little bit of marks on it. It needs to be wiped off. Whilst I was in just now getting unloaded, well, not whilst I was getting unloaded, but before getting unloaded and I was taking the straps off, I just went around the front wheels with a cloth and some window cleaner because they had a lot of brake dust on it, on just the front. So I've given them a wipe over. The mid-lift and the drive axle look fine, but obviously give them a brush later on with water. A brush with water. Give them a spray with water later. Should be good. Should be golden. But yeah, we're not looking to get back to the yard until 6 o'clock, plus we're going to get caught in traffic. I think we are going back via the A420, A34, A420 is where we saw that traffic earlier. I'm hoping it's clear. SatNav is not saying any traffic right now, so I'm hoping it's cleared up whatever was causing it. It was fine earlier when I came off it, so it must have been just like a little bit of an accident further on up the road just causing a bit of problem. I'm hoping, otherwise we'll be stuck in it, but never mind, never mind. So yeah, I'll probably see you back in the yard. I'll just have to be parked up or maybe even washing the truck, I don't know. I'll see you shortly, see you in a bit. Right, you joined me at 20 to 7. Do you remember that traffic we got caught in earlier? Yeah, we got caught in it again coming back, didn't we? SatNav said there was no traffic. We got there and there was definitely traffic. And we got there bang on 5 o'clock pretty much as well. So yeah, we got stuck. We got stuck in quite a bit of traffic. What should have only have taken 2 hours to get back has taken us 2 hours, 45 minutes in terms of driving time. In terms of physical time, what time did we leave? I can't even remember what time we left now. Like I said, it's 20 to 7. So it's late enough. I think we left like 3 o'clock or something. Maybe 4 o'clock, not sure. Oh, it doesn't matter. But yeah, anyway, back in the yard almost. I don't know whether anyone's going to be here. We need to get AdBlue. And I could do with washing the truck, but it's getting late. If the shutter's open and the wash is out, then I'll give it a blast. I'd like to give it a clean, but it is 27, I'd like to go in, do you know what I mean? Wife and kids I've not seen for 3 days. Is that sunroof shut? I think it is. Yeah, it's shut. Just double checking. I don't know whether that was someone waving at me or not, so I just waved back just in case. Right. What's the crack? Where are you going? You're coming down here. Is anyone here? Yes, I think they are. I think there is. The shutter is up. Can I get AdBlue? That's the question. That's the million-dollar question. Can I get in? Can I get AdBlue? Ha! Huh. Might have to drop the trailer here and then get AdBlue, you know? Let's have a look. Oh, I'm so tired. Got me about right there, I think. Right, so put it in neutral. That's gonna be the end of the video. I'm gonna drop the trailer, get some AdBlue, maybe wash the truck and then go home. But that's gonna be the end. I've just come over really tired all of a sudden. Never mind. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. Till next time, drive safe, stay safe. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, wherever it is, up there, down there, I don't know where it is. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.